Hi everyone! How would you like to learn two easy ways to add animations like this to your videos? Firstly, I'm going to show you how to animate static images in iMovie using keyframes. And after that, I'll show you a more professional way of adding animated Canva stickers to videos using a video editing tool like Filmora. If you're new to this channel, I'm Nicky Pasquier, and I teach startups and small businesses how to successfully market their brands online using some of the best marketing tips, tricks, and tools. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on that little bell notification so that you know when I publish a new video. So if you're ready to get started, let's hop over to Canva. So I'm on my Canva desktop and I'm going to show you an image of an ebook cover which I created a little bit earlier on. I've just added an iPad frame to it just to make it look like a mock-up really. And this is the image that we're going to animate in iMovie. Now all I need to do is download it by heading over to the top right-hand corner of my Canva toolbar and clicking on this downward arrow. I'm going to download this particular image as a PNG file, but most importantly, and actually crucially, I'm going to place a little tick in this tiny box here to select a transparent background. So when this image here is downloaded, there will be no background. You will need to have Canva Pro for this. So if you don't already have a Pro account, please do get your exclusive, no obligation, 45-day free upgrade using my affiliate link, which I'll give you a little later on in this video, so do keep watching. So once I've placed a tick in this box to select a transparent background, I'm just going to click on the purple button to download it to my laptop. The reason why I'm using a static image is because it's really quite tricky adding an animated graphic to iMovie. There is a workaround, but to be honest with you, it's quite fiddly and time consuming, and as a busy entrepreneur, it's not what you want. Once you've done that, upload it to the media section of iMovie. Now drag it onto the video timeline. Make sure you position it where you want it to appear on your video. Now go to the top right-hand corner of your iMovie toolbar where you will see this little icon. This is the video overlay settings and you need to click on it. Click on the blue drop-down button here and select picture in picture. The overlay now appears on top of your video clip. Hold your cursor down over the overlay to move it around and resize it by hovering your mouse over the blue corner buttons and dragging them out. To start the animation, drag the overlay where you want it to first appear. Going back to the video timeline, you'll find that there are some little tiny buttons in the top left and right hand corners of your overlay. You want to drag these back as far as they will go, because we don't want the overlay to fade in, we want it to appear immediately. So drag these out. Now move the playhead to the beginning of your overlay. Double click until you see this tiny keyframe toolbar. Click on the central button here to add a keyframe. This will mark the start of the animation. Now go back to your video timeline and drag the playhead to where you want your animation to end. Double click, go back to the overlay and drag the overlay to where you want it to finish. I also want the overlay to appear a little bit bigger when the animation is finished, so I'm going to drag the corner buttons out. And that's done. Now drag the playhead to the start of the video and click on the play button to see what your animation looks like. And that's pretty professional looking. And now let me show you a slightly more sophisticated way of adding animated Canva stickers into a video editing tool like Filmora. I've already opened up Filmora and I've added some media to the timeline. Now I'm going to hop over to Canva and search for a suitable animated sticker for my project. So I've decided to use this sticker of a downward arrow. What I did was go to Elements and search for stickers and arrows. And I just searched through the results until I found the best arrow for my project, which was this one. Now what I'm going to do is download my sticker as an MP4 video. You can't actually download a video with a transparent background like you did with an image file, but we're going to solve this problem in just a minute. So going back over to Filmora, I'm going to find my arrow sticker and add it to my project media. I'm going to drag it down to the video timeline like I did in iMovie and position it in the right place. I'm going to double click on it to select it. And this is the important difference between iMovie and Filmora. By double clicking my sticker, I can now edit it. And as you can see, I still have the white background. So to get rid of it, I'm going to find the Chroma key green screen tool. I'm going to select it by placing a tick in this little box here. I don't have a green screen, so I'm going to click on this little pipette here, take it over to my sticker, hover it over the white background and click on it to remove it. White background is gone, leaving just my sticker. I'm going to just hover my mouse over one of the corner buttons, hold my mouse down and drag on the corner button just to minimize the size. I'm going to drag the sticker into position and I'm going to run through this process once again because I want to add a sticker on the other side. And now if I drag the playhead back to the start of the video and run the video, I can watch my sticker animations. So now you have two ways of adding animated elements to your videos. I mentioned at the start of this video that you can upgrade to Canva Pro for free for 45 days using my exclusive affiliate link. So please do make the most of it. I'll leave the link in the description box below. If you have any quick questions, please do leave them in the comments box and I'll do my best to answer them. Otherwise, I'd be really grateful if you would support my channel by giving this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Of course, feel free to share it with your friends and I will see you in the next video.